Welcome everyone, I'm Marco Zuppone, I'm a Sentinel trainer based in Camberwell, UK, and in this short video I will talk to you about how to issue and deploy the SL-AdminMode keys. So first of all, what is an SL-AdminMode key and how many type of software keys do we have? There are three kinds of SL keys. Legacy, it is a type that we cannot generate anymore with the modern LDK 7.6. They were generated by previous version of LDK prior to version 6.0. Then we have the SL admin mode. They are the subject of this video and they offer a high degree of security and functionality, and they require the installation of the runtime environment to handle them. We will see why later. Then we have the SL user mode keys. We will talk about the SL user mode keys in another video. They do not require the runtime environment installed and they are stored directly in the file system of the machine. They are encrypted text files at the end. Now let's see better what is an SL admin mode key. You can think to an SL key like an hardware dongle. The SL admin mode key has mostly all the same features and capabilities of a hardware dongle. They have the read-only and read-writable memory area. They can store features. They have concurrency capabilities. They come with their unique serial number and they are marked with your batch code when they are produced. They have even a sort of virtual clock to avoid time tampering. They have something more than the hardware dongle. They are bound to the machine through the fingerprint. This is a very important difference. While it's nearly impossible to copy an HL key due to the hardware nature, it's really easy to make a bit identical copy of the hard disk where the SL keys are stored. This anyway does not mean that this attack is going to work. Thanks to this fingerprint, we are able to recognize that the machine with a clone drive is not the original one. How we do that and what is this fingerprint? So we use different strategies for physical and virtual machines and different protection schemes. At the deploy time, we collect some information from the machine, such as the CPU ID, the disk ID, motherboard ID, and all these attributes are used to form our fingerprint. I'm going to talk more in depth about these protection strategies in a future video. The SL admin mode license is stored on the disk, but it is not stored in the file system. So if you open the file explorer, you cannot access to this license at all. The license is stored in a special area of the hard drive. For this reason, this kind of key requires the installation of the runtime environment. The runtime environment comes with a device driver able to access the special area called the protected storage and talk with the SL admin mode key. So what does it happen when a protected application runs and seeks for the valid license? The Sentinel LDK library calculates the fingerprint of the machine and compares it with the one that is stored in the license. If the freshly calculated fingerprint does not match the one stored in the license is invalidated and the protected program will not run. In a future video, I will talk more in depth about this mechanism, how the fingerprint evaluation happens, and the different protection policy that you can choose when you define your license. Let's talk now about the license activation process. As we said, we need to gather the fingerprint of the destination machine before to issue the license. This gathering phase is called activation. In only one special case, we do not need to gather the fingerprint information from the machine before to issue the license. This special occasion is when we want to issue a trial license that is even called unlocked license. I will talk about trial unlock the licenses in another video. There are three main activation methods available. The automatic one, this method uses the LDK licensing API and the EMS web services. It requires internet access and it is totally transparent to the end user. Then we have the manual one. This requires internet access to reach, of course, the EMS customer portal and requires minimal input from the user. We will focus on this one in this video. And the last one is the offline method. The activation happens exchanging C2V and V2C files between the end user and the ISV. It does not require a direct internet access. Some prerequisites before to start with the manual activation through the portal. The end user needs to have the product key handy. He or she will need to log in to the EMS customer portal using this product key. The LDK runtime environment needs to be installed on the machine. It will help to store the newly received key in the protected storage and enable the communication with it. And the last one is that we need internet access to reach the EMS customer portal. Let's have a look now, before to proceed to the live demonstration, how the manual activation works in brief. First of all, the vendor, the ISV, creates an entitlement using Sentinel EMS. Then the entitlement creation triggers the creation of the product key, that is an alphanumeric string that is sent to the end user. The end user uses the product key to log in to the customer portal. The end user clicks on the online activation button. Then the customer portal starts to collect the fingerprint of the machine and issue the license. The license is installed on the local machine by the customer portal, and then the step E to F, they happen automatically without any need of user interaction. And now is the time to have a look to this process in the real world. I will start this demo directly from the entitlement tab of the LDK EMS. I demonstrated in a previous video how to define the product with its feature from scratch. So the first step to issue a license is to define an entitlement to consume. To create a new entitlement, I need first of all to select my batch code here, and then I click on the new entitlement button. We can optionally fill the customer details. In this way, the end user will receive an email with the product keys. Otherwise, we can send the product keys in another way directly by our email system or other ways. We select now the product key option, and then here we select how many keys we want to create and how many activations are consumed every time that the end user activates the product. We leave for this demo everything to the default, so only one. I then press add product and I go to select the product that I want to license. In this case, it's called MZ-SL. Now that everything is in place, we can press the produce button. One product key has been generated, and if I specify the end user in the entitlement and my SMTP is configured correctly, the end user is going to receive this product key. In this case, I have not specified a particular user, so I can download this key. Let's go to open it. As you can see, is only a GUID, mainly is only a alphanumeric string that we are going to send to our end user. Now I switch to the end user machine so we can play the role of the end user, and we try with this product key to activate the license. I am on the end user machine now, and we open Internet Explorer and we go to the customer portal. We are ready to enter our product key to login. Before to start this process, I want to show you that the runtime environment is installed on this machine and that currently we do not have any key. So if I go to the runtime environment, localhost port 1947, I click on Sentinel keys. As you can see, we do not have any key, hardware or software, connected to this machine. Okay, so let's return to the customer portal. And now we can log in with the product key that I received from my vendor. I enter the product key now and I press login. I can fill, in this case, optionally some information that will be retained from the vendor about who am I, my email address, my contacts. In this case, I skip this registering later. And now I can choose between online and offline activation. Offline activation will be the subject for another video. And now I can proceed with the online activation. Before to proceed, you can explore what products you are going to activate, what feature number will require, and some other details. So now is the time to activate this license, pressing the button Online Activation. As you can see, something is happening here, and the activation is successful. This is the serial number of the SL key created. And now let's have a look to this key in the ACC. Let's go there, localhost 1947, Sentinel keys. As you can see, now we have an admin mode, SL admin mode key. And if we have a look to the features, feature 1, 2, 3. We can even try to launch an application that requires this feature. A protected application that requires this feature is here. And I launch it. As you can see, I launched it and this is consuming this feature. So this is the end of our demo. We were able to issue a license and install the license SL admin mode on this machine. We are now able to run the protected application that consumes the feature 1, 2, 3 contained in the license that we provided on this machine. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you find it interesting. Please stay tuned on our channel for other interesting videos. Thank you and bye.